So in our previous session, what we have actually seen is a small intro about ANSYS and what are the guest features are available in ANSYS, like title bar and main menu and standard menu, toolbox, and what is that, status bar. So we have so far seen about the topics, and also we discussed about that what is the workflow of a CA software, like what is pre-processing and post-processing and solving part, what are the different kinds of solvers we have. These kinds will be already covered in our session. So today what we're going to see is what are the functions are available in the main toolbar, so or else main menu you can say. So before that, I'm Ranjit, so you are watching Simulation Tech. Okay, so let's get into the topic. First we will start from that main menu, so that is called File, View, Tools and Units, Extension, Jobs and Help. So these entities are available in main menus. So you guys are already aware of file. So when I place my cursor over the file, so it will show me so far familiar options like new, open and save, save as, save respiratory, so Anson archive and restore archive and import. So these options are available in that file option. So if you want to open a new file, so you can use a new command, or else you can use the shortcut as Control plus N. And if you want to open a project, so you can use Control plus O. So if I want to open a project now, so I just click over open. So it prompts to select me and folder, so where I have my saved files. So I have my saved files over here, so in ANSYS projects. So I just double click over here, so I have a project over here. So like the name is a played with whole problem, so I just select that particular file. So it is in the format of .wbj. okay, so I just click open. Now my project is get opened. So whenever you have saved a project, so that project is saved in the format of wbpj. So now my project is loaded over here. So just wait a minute, so it will be shown over here. Okay, so now the project has been successfully opened, so which we have already done before. And so we have a lot of options over here. So in our previous session itself also we have seen that analysis system. So this is called analysis system. In this analysis system we have a different component, so engineering data component, geometry component, model component and solution results components itself. So we will see in detail in our upcoming sessions about the sessions. And so this is a way to open a new project from open, or else you can use Control O. So if you want to change or save this file in another name, so you can just use save as option. So already this file is saved in that played with whole name problem, so that is the name of this problem statement. So you can, if you want to rename the problem, or else if you want to change any data and you have to save that particular file into a different file, so you can use the options called save as. So if I say save as, so it prompts to select a new name. So I can use a problem played with the whole problem one. So on say save, so now it is saved, so into another format. Okay, so in that title bar the name of that project is now changed to played with the whole problem to played with the whole problem one, right? So what about that the options called archive and restore archive? So the archive option is very useful. So when I just open that particular file which is saved in that, so this is the location where I save in my project. So my current project is opened, so that's why it shows me in dot format backup. So whenever I close my project, so it will automatically vanish. So this is my two projects. So one is played with the whole problem and another one is played with the whole problem one. So see, this is my project. So its size is actually a 230 KB. So whenever we want to copy your project to another system, or you want to send your project to somebody, so you cannot send this file standalone. So it cannot execute it by that ANSYS. So whatever the version, regardlessly. So it needs the supporting file. See, this file has a supporting files of this file. So if I say right click that particular folder and say properties, it shows me a size of 9.96 MB, but the actual size of this project is 230 KB. So if you want to execute this particular file, you need the supporting files. See, without that you can't execute that file. So always you have to remember that whenever you copy your file, so you need to copy both of them. So this file and this file, and these two files are kept into a particular folder. So whenever you open that particular file, it always needed a supporting file, right? So to be on safer side, if you want to transfer your project to an any other PC, so you can use this option called archive. So I want to send this project to somebody, so I can archive this project. So whenever I say archive, so it prompts me to select a name. So I can say it is a plate with the whole problem modified. So I can just renamed it as like this and say save. So note that this is saved in the format of .wbpz format. So it's like a zip file. So it says me is I want a result and points. Yeah, I want this. And say okay. So it will be saved as a zip file. So which includes both the project file execution file as well as the supporting files. Now my project is saved. So I can open that location and say refresh. See, I have a zip file. So played with the whole problem with modified. So whenever you want to open this file or unzip this folder, so you can just use file. If you have an option called restore archive, so if you click on restore archive, it prompts to select that particular zip file. So I have the zip file over here, so you can also check over here whatever the supporting formats are supported by the rearchive or restore archive option in ANSYS itself. So it is very useful. So whenever you can you want to send your project to somebody or whatever it may be. So hope you will understand what is archive and what is restore archive. So these are all the main options available in your file entities or file entities menu. So you can access that recently opened problem, or you can export your reports, like you want to print your results, that is also possible. So likewise you can use that all the options over here. So the next feature is view. So what was view? Whatever you can see in that current window. So as I said before, this is a welcome screen of ANSYS Workbench. So you want to change any entities over here, like I don't want a toolbox over here, or else I need an additional property bar over here. So you can change from view. So right now there is no entities for properties here. So if you want to create a property entities, just go to view. So you have an option called properties, just enable this. So now the property entities will be shown over here. So if you click this project schematic, so the information related to this current project will be displayed over here. And so if you don't want, you can just uncheck that particular objects, so it will be vanished. Right now our project schematic will be disabled, because in that view, so instead of selecting a toolbox, instead of selecting properties, I can unselect that project schematic. So right now I reselect that project schematic and again unselect the projects. Okay, so now all the entities will be come again. So if you accidentally close any one of these entities, like I close the toolbox and I close that project schematics, so right now I don't have anything. So similar error will also occurs when you newly installed your software. So you don't, somebody says that, so sir, I don't have a project schematic over my ANSYS or what I will do. So you can simply go to views and you have an option called reset workspace or reset window layout. So I can say reset window layout. So now that entire options will be resetted back to a normal stage. So this is the one option you can use, or else you can directly click on that toolbox and project schematics and whatever the options you need to display it over here. So you can just click on OK. So that is the options available in view. So in tools itself, you can check your what is the version of your software and what are your license preference. So and then you have an options. It's a system software options. Just click on that options. You will have a lot and lot of options over here, like project management, right from that appearance, graphics, user interface, or else if you want to change that geometry input properties, that is also possible. So if I say geometry imports, so what designer design geometry or editor you prefer? So in ANSYS itself, we have two different editors. So one is called a design modeler. So design modeler is a traditional one, and another one is called space climb direct modeler. So space climb direct modeler is a advanced based designing software. So either you can design or edit your model by using a design climb or design modeler. So in our entire session we will see about design modeler. So I defaultly prefer design modeler, so I can change to design modeler and say okay. So whatever the changes you need to make over here, so you can make over there. So you want to change the graphics interactions like mouse gesture and shortcuts, you can change over from here also. So these options are available in tools and options. Okay, so on the last thing was very important, like units. So obviously you need to set the units for a projects. So it's very mandatory one, right? So you can select the whatever the unit system you want to work from, SI units or metric or metric tons or whatever the units. So or you want those defined your user defined unit system, that is also possible. So just click unit system. So right now in that options we have access only 5 unit systems, right? So if you open that unit system detailedly, so you can have a lot and lot of around 17 combinations of units are available. So whatever the unit system you need, you just select from here. Or else if you want to create a new unit system, that is also possible. So either you can import from offline data, or you can export that particular data you want to transfer to another computer. So that is also possible. Or else if you want to duplicate a particular system, so I want to duplicate this metric ton, so just select that particular unit system and say duplicate. And if you want to make some modifications, so I want to change the angle itself only, or else I want to change the current ampere units only, so whatever the changes, so you can modify and save it as a new one. So and then you can use for your project, so that is also possible. So these are all the options are available in that main menu. And so coming to toolbox, so in toolbox we have a different types of analysis systems, and we have components and some other options are also available here. So these options are discussed in our later session. So let's see about what is analysis system. So before getting to that analysis, so you need to understand that what are the different analysis systems are available in ANSYS itself. Okay, let's see about that engineering analysis. For that I need to delete this particular analysis system and say delete. So this operation will delete the entire unshared data in that selected system. So let's okay. Anyways, I don't want that particular data right now. Okay, so let's get into that engineering analysis. Okay. So first, engineering analysis is furtherly classified into two broad categories. So what are the categories? So the two categories are, first is structural analysis. And the second is thermal analysis. So furtherly, the thermal analysis will be classified into two types, and structural analysis can be classified into 5 types. So I can just so what are the two categories? So first is steady state thermal. Steady state thermal. And the second is transient thermal. So what are the different categories are available in structural analysis? So as I said before, it is furtherly classified into a 5 categories. Okay, so first I will start from, so I can use a dark color over here. Static structural, so which is a familiar analysis, static structural analysis. And the second analysis is dynamic analysis. So the third is spectrum. So it's spectrum, and then fourth is buckling analysis. Fifth may be explicit, so which uses explicit solvers. While we're discussing about that solvers, I say that ANSYS have two different types of solvers. One is implicit solver and another one is explicit solver. For explicit dynamics analysis, it uses the explicit solver, right? So the dynamic is, so furtherly we have another category, so that is divided into a 3 main categories. 1 and 2 and 3. So again I can use another color and say the dynamic analysis is furtherly classified into a model. So it's not model, it's a model analysis. And harmonic analysis. And the last one is transient dynamic. So transient dynamic analysis. So these are all the different types of analysis which is available in engineering analysis. So engineering analysis first classified into a two types, so structural analysis and thermal analysis, and then furtherly can be classified, structural can be classified into 5 different types: a static analysis and dynamic analysis, spectrum analysis, buckling analysis and explicit analysis. And then furtherly the dynamic analysis is classified into model analysis, harmonic analysis and transient dynamic analysis. And thermal analysis can be classified into a steady state and transient thermal. So likewise, you can have all the analysis in that analysis system, like, so buckling analysis, you have buckling analysis and explicit analysis, harmonic analysis and model, random vibrations and static structural, transient structural. So all the analysis are available in that analysis system. But you may notice that one thing in over here. So what is that SIMSIF and another term called Abaqus? Have you noticed that? So all the terms are repeated, right? So eigenvalue buckling analysis 1 and eigenvalue buckling analysis 2, but in the bracket it says that it's called as a SIMSIF. What is that SIMSIF? SIMSIF. And another one is Abaqus. So Abaqus. So these are all nothing but it is a solver. So either if you want to, so already we have discussed about that solver, right? So in ANSYS itself, it has a implicit solver and explicit solver. So only for explicit dynamics, the explicit solver is used. For the remaining analysis, implicit solver is used. So implicit solver is furtherly divided into a direct solver and iterative solvers. So depend upon that problems, that solver can be chosen. So apart from that, it has a SIMSIF. You want to solve the problem in SIMSIF, you can choose SIMSIF. Or if you want to solve the particular problem in Abaqus, you can choose Abaqus itself. So you have 3 options, like normal and Abaqus and SIMSIF. So depend upon your need, you can choose the particular analysis system and drag over the project schematic area, and you can perform your analysis. Right, so these are all the different categories of analysis. In our next session we will see in detail about what are the different sessions available in that analysis system. So I can just clear that screen and drag over and one particular system over here. So it will take a while to load. Okay, so it gets loaded. Right, so just note it down here over. So we have a different components over here. So first is engineering component and geometry, model, setup, solution and results. So it's just like a ready-made system. So whenever we want to, if you want to solve a problem, what are the elements you need to solve a problem? Like you need a geometry, you need an environment to create a mesh and adding a boundary conditions, and you need an environment to view the result. So these all the elements are combined together as a standardized one. So that is called analysis system. Or else if you want to, if you want a separate component system, for example, I need a separate engineering data itself. So that is also possible. I can drag the engineering data separately, or else I need a separate meshing environment. So that is also possible. So I need to perform mesh itself only. So I can drag the mesh from over here, or else if you want to view the results, you can drag and drop the results from the component systems. So these are all separate components. So those, this is all about ready-made components. So that has a series of components which is needed for a particular analysis, like engineering data and geometry, model, setup, solution, results, all together are combined as a single system. So that is called analysis system. These are all system components. Okay, so hope you will understand that what is the main difference between that analysis system and that separate component systems. And in our next session we will detailedly explain about what is engineering data, and then we go for geometry. So after that completion of geometry, we will start that analysis. So that is all for today. Hope you will like that video. So if you like that video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. So see you on next video.